Indian ringneck parakeets are one of the most beautiful species of parrot available in the pet trade. I think they're a very underrated parrot, and today we're going to talk about all their care requirements and everything you need to know about Indian ringneck parakeets. I'm Adam, this is Zazu, this is Wiccan's Wicked Reptiles, stick around. Indian ringneck parakeets are medium-sized parrots from sub-Saharan Africa. They bite people's ears. They're also from Southeast Asia and parts of the Middle East as well. When you want to get any pet, you want to know how big does this thing get? That's the most important question because you're going to need to house this thing, you need to feed this thing, you're going to need to give it some exercise. And the really nice thing is with ringneck parakeets, they don't get much bigger than this. Zazu is about 12 weeks old. He's not quite full grown, but he's pretty close. They get an average of about 16 inches and they got this really long tail. But in terms of size, they're not much different from a conure. They do bite your ears more, though, however. Being that they get to this size so quickly, I don't think it's important to go over how quickly they grow, because at 12 weeks, they're going to be pretty much the size that you want them to be. Cage size is another important consideration, and with this, it's going to be a little bit different than a conure. Because they have such a long tail, you want to give them more height. So you want something around 24 inches in width, 24 inches, well, I guess all the way around, right? 24 by 24 and 36 inches tall. That's minimum. You can always give them a bigger space. Parrots like Zazu can live together. You can cohabitate them. You're going to want a bigger enclosure than the minimum size requirement that I just described. But you don't need a super huge enclosure, just depending on how many birds you want to keep in the same space. Heating and humidity. Coming from the reptile background, this is something that's usually a big requirement or a big talking point. But with parrots, it's not really a huge talking point, especially with the Indian ringneck. They are happy if you're happy. If it's too hot for you, it's too hot for them. If it's too cold for you, it's too cold for them. Keep them at room temperature, room humidity. They are pretty hardy species. They do have a significant night drop in the wild, and it is very hot and very humid in a lot of places that they live, being they have such a giant geographic range. But just keep them safe and keep them happy and keep them comfortable. Whatever your room temperature is that makes you feel comfortable, that's gonna make them feel comfortable too. And in terms of lighting, this is another thing that's big with reptiles, but with birds, as long as they have a day and night cycle, like your house, right? Because they're not gonna be kept in a glass aquarium in a reptile room, likely. You're gonna have them somewhere in your house where they can interact with you, and we're gonna get to why that's really important in a moment. But as long as they've got a day and night cycle like what you've got, right? So in the winter, it's a little bit shorter than it is in the summer. Just make sure that they have the same sort of day and night cycle that you do. Diet is another really important thing as well. You gotta feed these things now that you know how big they get and how to keep them properly. I learned today something I didn't know. Indian ringnecks really love as treats your fingers and your ears. But as a staple diet, I would suggest something that's just a high quality parrot diet or high quality parakeet diet that's rich with fruits and nuts, grains and seeds. Not really fruits as much, that's kind of more of a treat thing. So seeds, grains, and nuts is kind of what you have in that high quality diet. But if you were to talk to a parrot expert or do specific research on their diet, you'll find the brand that's available in your area that would be right for your Indian ringneck. Treats are really important with these guys too. Millet is great. Fruits and vegetables are great too. Every parrot is gonna have their own personality and their own taste, just like a human. So you're just gonna have to try to figure out what your bird likes. And of course, supplementation is something that's important as well. Calcium is something you're gonna wanna make sure that they have. It's really important for their health. It could be as simple as a cuttlefish bone, ground up oyster shells, something like that. Do specific research on this. Don't take this care guide as a Bible and then go buy yourself an Indian ringneck. Do specific research, especially on their dietary requirements. Behavior is a big one, especially with parrots, right? If you're thinking about getting a parrot, you're gonna wanna interact with it. This isn't some sort of put it on a shelf and never touch it type of animal, especially if you want it to ever be able to handle it. They need a tremendous amount of attention and a tremendous amount of training in order to keep them tame. Now, Zazu, who is no longer on my shoulder, you'll notice, that's for a specific reason. He was biting the heck out of me. I think he's coming back down right now. Indian ringnecks get bored very easily as well. So you want to make sure they've got lots of toys in their enclosure, something that I should have mentioned with the size of the enclosure. They have a food bowl and a water bowl in there, of course, as well. And if you keep them entertained, then they'll stop eating your arms and your ears. Now this, of course, is a very young parrot. We've only had this guy for about a week and a half now, so it's not normal for them to be bitey like that if you give them enough attention and if you keep them occupied, because it is a very intelligent animal. These guys are great speakers. They've got a vocabulary of up to 250 words is what I've read from my research. That's about where they're gonna be. So they are considered a very intelligent speaker. They make all sorts of cool noises, and they do this really cool head bobbing thing that I've seen lots of other birds do as well. And I'm sure you're thinking to yourself, well, you just said that Zazu's a boy and he doesn't have that ring around his neck, so what's going on? Well, first of all, if you don't know, Indian ringnecks gain their rings as they age. So as they get a little bit older, they're gonna get their ring. So I think it's about a year when they start getting their ring. It's gonna be a nice black, a very nice contrast, especially with the color, and we're gonna get into ringneck colors in a moment. And then if they're a female, they're never gonna get the ring. That's why we got the male in the first place, is my girlfriend wanted one of these guys for a very long time. We did our research, and now we've got one, and Zazu is gonna grow up to be a very handsome man with a very handsome ring, and we'll keep you informed. We'll put a video up once he starts getting that as well. And a really cool thing with treats, there's these little balls of seeds that my girlfriend gives Zazu all the time, like you see right here, and he'll grab them with his feet, and then he'll eat it with his feet. And I know that parrot people have seen this forever. They think it's super cool. I think this is like the most interesting thing, to watch a parrot eat with its foot. And before we get into what colors these guys come in, the different morphs that you can get, let's talk about price and availability, because all of this doesn't really mean anything to you if you can't afford one or if you can't find one. Well, you're gonna need to find a breeder. You're not gonna really find these guys in pet stores all that often, unless you're in like a giant city with tons of competition for exotic species like this. But when you can find one, you can find a breeder. There's lots of Facebook pages you can go to. You go on Reddit, you can find someone who breeds them as well. We had to go about an hour and a half from home in order to get this guy, and we live in an area where we're pretty close to Toronto, which is an area where we got this guy in the first place. Now, the price. This is something that's a little bit different than most of the animals I talk about on this channel, because most of the animals don't cost $1,000 like Zazu did. You're gonna spend somewhere around $500 to $1,500 depending on your area. I did a bunch of research looking on Craigslist and Kijiji in different markets, and I found them as low as $500. It looked a little bit sketchy because the next closest one was $800 in that area, and then they went all the way up to $1,500. There's gonna be a number of factors, including age, if it's a male or a female, and what color it is, that determine how much these animals go for. So now you've got your cage set up, you have your feed all ready to go, everything is ready for your parrot to come home. Now you're gonna have to pick what color you want, because with these birds, there are so many different colors that you can choose from. Zazu here is a violet purple type. In the wild, you're gonna see mostly green. That's gonna be the majority, and with a little bit of blues and grays. There's violets. There's really, teal is another really cool one that I really like. And that's it. That is the Indian ringneck. That's everything you need to know. Everything that I talked about, make sure that you do a bunch of research specifically on these topics, especially the diet requirements with these animals before you go and get one. Do tons of research, it's the most important thing. And of course, because I do mostly reptile videos, if you love reptiles, come back to the channel, watch the other videos. That's what we mainly focus on here. If you haven't already hit that subscribe button, I'd really appreciate that. And because we do videos twice a week, that means that I'll see you on Thursday.